Hey Bill, big fan of your work. This is Hassan from Tunisia. I'm a geoscientist at the University of Freiburg in Germany. My question for you today is, how can it be that human beings still can't communicate with animals? I mean, we have powerful computers by now. Isn't it just easy to just record a lot of data, let the computers look for patterns and play them back and analyze the responses? Imagine all the implications. Animals can become better tools for us or even closer friends. Heck, we can even ask them what their perspective on life is. I hope you answer my question. Have a nice day.
Hello, Hasek. Did I pronounce it correct? I'm doing my best. I only heard it once and the sound's not too loud. Hasek, greetings. Thank you for your question. Can we communicate with animals better than we do now? Well, let me say, I've spent a lot of time with dogs. And I really have a sense of what they're thinking. I certainly have a sense of when they're happy and when they're sad. I've spent a little bit of time with gorillas. Now, I'm talking about a tiny amount of time. But you can certainly tell when a gorilla is happy, when a gorilla is angry, and you can also tell when gorillas are communicating with each other. Now, this is one of the things I wonder about all the time. Is there a gradient? Is there an increasing, a stair step of intelligence? Of language skill between, let's say, a gibbon, a bonobo, a gorilla, a chimpanzee, a human? Is there a gradient of intelligence from cow to horse to zebra to giraffe? I don't know. But these animals certainly, the mammals anyway, certainly have emotions that we can detect and interact with. But I'm very skeptical so far that animals really ponder the universe and our place within it. And I'm very skeptical that bonobos or chimpanzees have developed something like the periodic table of the elements. However, with that said, if you ever saw the movie Up, which is an animated movie, I think the word poignant in English would be very descriptive. It's bittersweet. But there's a fabulous scientific premise, a science fiction premise, where the inventor has a collar that enables dogs to speak English. It's fabulous. And I don't know, maybe they've translated it into German and you've watched it in German. But wouldn't that be fun if you could talk to dogs in English or human language sentences? Wouldn't that just be the most fun ever? But I'm skeptical. Just for example, when a human dies, we go to all kinds of trouble. We've got funeral homes and cemeteries and so on. But when a primate dies, there is apparently a period of mourning in the troop or the barrel of monkeys, of chimpanzees. But then they get over it much more quickly than humans do. And I wonder, is that for evolutionary, like they have to get over it in order to go forage for food and get on with their lives? Or is their memory of it just kind of not as intense as humans because they don't have this language, that reinforces this person's memory and the interactions you have with this, your fellow primate? I wonder this. So to answer your question, I am absolutely not sure. But intuitively, it seems like this gradient of intelligence would limit the amount that we could talk with animals. Now, by the way, I don't know if you've ever been into Aquaman. He can talk to fish. He talks to fish. Tarzan, king of the jungle, talks to all his animal guys, people, animal friends. They're not people. And so that is certainly something that humans have thought about for centuries, or those myths wouldn't exist. Hasek, one more thing about using computers to communicate with animals. Keep in mind that the computers have to be programmed. Somebody would have to, at least early here in the 21st century, computers are not self-organizing enough to decide to make a program to communicate with animals. But in the ornithology community, people who study birds, they work really hard to understand bird calls. They record them, reproduce them, try to communicate with birds. Certainly people have tried to imitate whale sounds and marine mammal sounds, but I don't think it's to the point where anybody's taken a meeting with them and talking about the fundamental theorem of calculus or the rocket equation or how to raise crops underwater or whatever it is. So I'm interested in this gradient of intelligence, and it'll be up to you to write the computer program that enables this idea of yours. The answer is definitely maybe.